I want to tell you, it is a miracle that that leg is still there. Welcome to another edition of the King's Court. And finally, I get a chance to tell you people what really took place. The truth of the fateful incident leading up to SummerSlam. I'll never forget it. I couldn't wait to get to Auburn Hills. I couldn't wait to get my hands on Bret the Hitman Hart. I took the first flight into Detroit, Michigan. I couldn't wait. I ran off that plane. I ran to get a rental car. One of those big, long, luxury rental cars made in Detroit, Michigan. And as I drove that car out of the lot, I started realizing something was not exactly right. When I realized the radio didn't work and the windshield wipers didn't work, as a matter of fact, nothing worked on that lousy car, especially not the brakes or the airbag. Because I want to tell you, those stupid Detroit drivers, as I pulled off I-75 and was heading down Championship Drive, that's when it happened. And I don't care what they say, it was not my fault. Some little old blue-haired lady who should have had her license revoked about 50 years ago pulled out in front of me. And she caused about a 10-car pileup. Oh, when I think about how I had to pull myself out of that fiery wreckage and hobble up past the carnage, an ordinary man wouldn't have even survived. But all I had on my mind was getting to Auburn Hills, the palace, and getting my hands on Bret Hart. But the doctors stopped me. They said, you can't wrestle in your condition. Your leg's mangled beyond belief. The nurses wanted to put a splint. They wanted to put pins in my ankle. They wanted to put a cast on. I said, no, I don't have time for that. I've got a date with destiny. I've got a mission to accomplish. What happened when I walked into that, well, when I hobbled into that ring with doctor's permission, orders not to wrestle, I knew that I had to do something. I knew that Bret Hart could not go without being taken care of. So what do you do when you can't wrestle? When you're a king, you appoint somebody to take your place. And who better to do it than my court jester, Doink the Clown? Well, Doink, you imbecilic idiot, if you had done what you promised me you could do, I wouldn't be sitting here in this condition. You told me you could take care of Bret Hart, but you didn't do it. And that left it up to me. I still had to go in the ring, on crutches, mind you, because Bret Hart, I wanted you so bad. I wanted you, Bret Hart. But what kind of man are you who would take advantage of a cripple? What kind of man are you who would do what you did to a handicapped person? The Department of Motor Vehicles have already sent me my handicap sticker to put in my back window. But no, Bret Hart, the big shot that you are, you put that hold of yours on my leg and you tried to snap it. You tried to end my career. You tried to break my leg. And not only you, your whole family poured into the ring. I looked up and I saw both of your brothers helping you apply more pressure to my leg. I want to know, Bret Hart, what kind of man you are. Well, I can tell you this. I know what you are not. You, Bret Hart, are not a king. You are not the king. Because even though I lay flat on my back in excruciating pain, I could still hear that ring announcer's voice as it echoed throughout the palace at Auburn Hills, as it echoed throughout all the homes throughout the world. The winner of the big match, the undisputed king, Jerry the King Lawler. Yeah. Oh.